Hi, I'm Renee from Martha and Me, and today I'm going to teach absolute beginners how to make this washcloth. For this project, you're going to need several items. You're going to need yarn, and I've chosen to use this tube yarn because it is larger and it's just easier to demonstrate on, but you can use many kinds of yarn. The only problem with the yarn is, it's not really a problem, but the only issue you need to think about is you must match your crochet hook, which you'll also need a crochet hook, with the size of the yarn. So my yarn is the type that would need a 6 millimeter crochet hook, and that's what I've got. You'll also need to match your tapestry needle. You use a tapestry needle, one of your supplies, and that should be able to handle, the eye of the tapestry needle should be able to handle the size of the yarn you've got. You'll also need 2 stitch markers. So back to the yarn. I like cotton yarn for this because it dries so much nicer. I really like the Lion Brand 24/7. It is smaller, so it'll take more stitches, but I really like the finished product. But for today, we are going to use this large tube yarn here. So before you're done, you're going to know how to hold your yarn. You're going to know how to hold your crochet hook. You're going to know how to do a slip knot. I'll teach you to chain stitch, and you'll learn how to double crochet, which is what most of the body of this is, double crochet. And then you're going to learn how to fasten off your product and tidy things up. So that's quite a bit, but you will be surprised at how easily it is to learn and how much enjoyment you're going to get out of this. So let's start with how to handle the yarn. The left hand for me, since I'm right-handed, I crochet right-handed, the left hand for me is where I provide the tension for the yarn. And you can't have yarn just flipping through here. It'll be too loose, and you can't have it too tight, or your work will be too tight. So this hand, the left hand in my case, will provide some of the tension. And I hold the tail of my yarn, and I scoop in here between my little finger and my ring finger. And there the yarn will be between my little finger and my ring finger, and the tail is hanging down. Now take your hand and flip it 180 degrees so what you see the back of your hand. And now take your pointing finger and slip that under the yarn. And you'll see that you have yarn over your pointer finger, under these two middle fingers, and over your little finger. And now when you turn your hand perpendicular, this is the perfect spot to crochet, because just test that and pull and you'll feel a tiny bit of drag. That's just the right amount to provide nice tension. Now, how are we going to hold our crochet hook? There's 2 very valid ways, equally effective, and it just depends upon your preference. I tend to hold my crochet hook in the knife position. It's just like you're holding a knife when you're cutting meat. So my crochet hook is over the last 3 fingers in the palm of my hand. I put my thumb on that thumb rest there, and I use the pointer finger just as a kind of a, you know, easier to manipulate a little bit. Now some people swear by the pencil method, and it's exactly like it sounds. You hold it like you hold a pencil. And you have your hook on top of your hand with those 3 fingers underneath, and again your thumb on the thumb rest. And you'd use your wrist more in guiding that crochet hook, which is one of the reasons I don't really like this for me, because I have a little bit of arthritis in my wrist and this just doesn't feel right to me. Use the method that feels right for you and you'll be fine. So we know now how to hold our yarn. We know how to hold our hook and we're ready to start crocheting. So what we're going to do is do a slip knot. And again, there's many different ways to do a slip knot. If you know how to do a slip knot, you don't have to worry about this. I didn't, and I tell you, it took me a little while to learn. I've taught before how to do it with using the finger, wrapping it around the finger. Today, I'm going to teach a different way. I'm going to teach you how to just do it with your hands. And this is the way I do it sometimes, often. I make a loop over my hands. So the tail end, I start with the tail end down toward me. And I start with the yarn over my hands, over those fingers. And I just bring it down. And you can go over two fingers, three fingers, doesn't matter. You're just making a loop. And let your yarn dangle, your tail end dangle. Then you take it off your fingers and pinch where that joins. And now the tail end is dangling. You can hold it upright. It's dangling. And it forms a line between that circle. You've got a loop. You've got a circle. And you can see that that tail end hangs down behind the circle. And it's in a line. And now just reach in there and pinch that line. And pull up. And you've got a slip knot. And now you can slip your crochet hook on it and pull on the tail end and you have a very nice slip knot. Okay, let's go through that one more time so we have it down pat. We have our yarn and I put the yarn over the top of my hand with the tail end down behind. I wrap the yarn around and make a loop. Take it off my fingers, pinching the top of that loop to keep it into a circle. And my tail end then hangs down and it makes a line behind the circle. Reach through and grab that line. Pull that up. You can just remove your hand, pull that up, and you have a slip knot. Put your crochet hook in there. Pull down on your tail end of your yarn. And you've got a crochet hook. Now, if you didn't catch that, if you want to look at that a few more times, just go back on your video and back it up and watch it again. So we've got the slip knot. That's the way we'll always start in crochet. You have to have some way to hook it on to your hook. So if you'll see this, look at the bend in the crochet hook, the shape of the crochet hook. This is a little fatter down here at this end, and it actually gets skinnier up toward the hook end. If you keep your crochet loop always up here, it will tighten down too much and your loops will be too small and you'll have very tight piece of work and it's just too hard to work in that tight piece. So be sure you always, every stitch, you slide that loop down into the fat part so that your loop stays large and you're able then to pull that crochet hook through the loop. If you look, the loop makes a teardrop shape and you need to be able to easily slip that hook in and out of there because you're going to be pulling another piece of yarn with you. So now with that in mind, let's get our hand in position. We learned how to do that. We scoop that up between the little finger and the ring finger. We take our hand to switch palm down and we take our pointer finger and put that under, turn perpendicular and look at this. We are all set to crochet. I also take my thumb and my longest finger and kind of pinch that knot, and later on it'll be the working end of your yarn. You'll have a piece of work here, many stitches. I always move that up so that I can keep pulling slightly and make sure that I have that teardrop shape on every single stitch and I'm able to get my hook in and out. So I know that took a while, but we need to know the basics so we can get started. Now we'll learn to do the chain stitch, and every piece of crochet, with very few exceptions, starts with some chains. So this is how we do it. We're holding our yarn, as we've been taught, we're holding our hook, whichever way you like. And now I take my hook and I push it toward me, toward the palm of my hand, and then I push it down toward my fingers and up. And in doing so, I have done what they call yarn over, and I am now able to pull that yarn through the loop that I've already got on my hook, and I've done one chain. Now let's do that again. We take the hook end toward our palm, we move it down to the fingers, and we move it up, and I'm in a perfect position then to hook that piece of yarn and bring it through, and I've got two. So let's do that again. Down, back, up, pull through. 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 And if you've noticed, I do always take my hand and move it up, move it up, move it up, so that I'm able to help pull that into a teardrop shape so that my yarn can go through. Now let's see how many stitches I'm talking, so I don't know how many stitches I've done. And to do that, you're gonna have to be able to kind of deconstruct mentally those stitches. And look at this, what I see on my hook are V's. Let's put them here so you can see them better. Get a little something I can point with. There's a V there, the V there, the V there, a V there, a V there, a V there. Every V is a chain stitch. So we have one, we don't count the one on our hook. We have one, two, three, four, five, six. I've done six chain stitches. Now for this piece, we want to get a finished product of about 7 by 7. But we don't want to sit here and watch me do this, the whole thing. So we're going to make a sample piece, and you'll be able to use that information to make your own as big as you want. So for this piece, I'm going to do 11 chains. And so I have 6, and there's 7. Notice me moving my hand up. 8. Let's do 9. Remember, down, back, up, pull through, down, back, up, pull 3, and 11, down, back, up, pull through. And that is our 11 chain stitches. Like I say, you're going to want your finished washcloth to be 6 to 7 inches. And but we're going to proceed on this swatch, and it's going to have 11 stitches. And to do that, we go into this second V, the second chain from the end. And we don't count the one on the crochet hook. This is the first one, and then this is the second one. So we go into that second one. And for double crochet, I loop over my yarn before I even start. And now I go into that, and I pull more yarn through there till I have 3 loops on my hook. And then I do the yarn over, pull through 2. And if you have to squeeze, wheedle, move, just do however you can do to get that through, especially as you're a beginner. Now I'm left with 2 loops on my hook, and I take that yarn over again, and I pull it through both those. And I've done my first double crochet. Now take your stitch marker and stick it through that first, the top of that first double crochet. Now we're going to do another double crochet. We're going to go double crochet all the rest of the way through here. So we do yarn over, into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through. And see, I have three loops on my hook. I yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Now, we don't mark these anymore because we just want the end, so it just makes it easier to find out where we are. And so we have already marked that row. And we just keep doing this all the rest of the way, and there should be 10 of these. So yarn over, into the next stitch, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Yarn over, into the next stitch, yarn over, pull that up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Now we have four already. We should have six more. Last one. And we've done our first row of double crochet. Now, like I said, you're going to want about a 6 to 7 inch product, washcloth. So you'll do more than this, but for the purposes of this video, that's what we want to do. Now we're going to turn and go back in the other row. And for double crochet, even single crochet, half double crochet, I just chain one. This is controversial. I just find this makes my sides nice and straight. So I chain one and then I turn. You're gonna do this on every row. When you get to the end of the row, you're gonna chain one and then turn. And then I yarn over and go into that very first hole. Now look at these holes. I've got the yarn on the hook and I've got my chain stitch right here. And so this right here is the very first stitch that I'm going to go into. And you can sometimes pull on your yarn and it makes it a little more obvious. So I always yarn over for double crochet and go into that stitch. And then I pull through and I have three loops on my hook and I pull through two and I pull through two. And now since this is the first double crochet of the row, I'm going to mark, and you're going to notice when we get back to the first stitch marker we put in, how much easier this makes it to know where we are on the row. So get it under both of those legs of the V. Go right through there and lock that in and forget about it for just a minute. And we're going to do the rest of this row. Remember, we do yarn over, go into the stitch, and when I go into the stitch, I pick up both legs of that V. Both legs of the V are on top of my hook. And then I pull through the yarn so that I have three loops on my hook. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Yarn over, go through the next stitch, pull up, I got three on my hook. Go through two, go through two. And we'll just keep on going right across for the rest of these. And when we get to the end, you'll see why that stitch marker is important. Now, if your yarn gets too taut, if the ball of yarn, just stop, pull out some yarn from the ball there and get set, because you don't want the tightness. You want every single stitch to be the proper tension. So a yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Now here I am to the end of my row, and if I didn't have a stitch marker there, I might think that was the end of my row. But it's not. And we know it's not because I put a stitch marker in the very first stitch of the row, but it isn't obvious at the ends of the row, and that's why the stitch marker is so important. So now we can yarn over, go in to that stitch that the stitch marker's in, pull through two. Now that is the end of the row, and we can go from there. So my piece, I have two rows. If you'll notice, we did double crochets on both rows, but they both look different, don't they? This is because this is the front of the double crochet. Let me use this as a pointer. And you can see I have a little V that went into the row before it. And then I have these three stitches here, and I have the V on top. That whole post, we call that a post, is a double crochet. But this is the back of the double crochet, and it looks entirely different. If we turn this over, now this looks like the back of the double crochet, and this looks like the front. So that's, you need to familiarize yourself with what your stitches look like, and it'll help you in your crocheting as you go along. So we come to the end of the row, and do you remember what we did? We chained one and turn. And then we just proceed to double crochet down the row. Yarn over, go into that very first stitch, yarn over, pull through. I have three loops on my hook. I pull through two. And now my must-do step is to put this stitch marker in here so that I'll know where the very first stitch is, or the very last, depending on where you are in the row. Yarn over into the next stitch, and proceed with your double crochets. I needed to get more yarn because it was starting to get tight with the ball of yarn. So I just pulled out more yarn, and now I can just go back in again. It doesn't take but a second to get myself set up again. So don't be afraid to drop that yarn and adjust things and get started again. Okay, I'm coming toward the end, and I know I have one. This might throw me for a loop, but I know I have one more stitch because I have the stitch marker in here. And so I yarn over and do my last double crochet of this row in the first double crochet of the previous row. Pull through, yarn over, pull through two, and over, pull through two. Now we have learned how to hold the yarn. We've learned how to hold the hook. We've learned how to chain stitch. We've learned how to double crochet. And, oh, I forgot, we learned how to slip stitch. Now, this is just going to be our little swatch that we're using for the training. And so you'll keep on proceeding. You'll do your 6 inches or 7 inches wide and enough rows to make 6 or 7 inches tall. And then you're going to want to fasten off. To do that, your very last stitch, pull it up. Take your scissors and cut off. Leave a long tail because you'll need that long tail in part of this process. And now just pull through. Just pull that loop through and pull it tight a little bit. Now take the tapestry needle I told you to get and thread the tapestry needle. Sometimes the yarn is so thick that you'll need to compress, and I pull it on my tapestry needle and pinch it, and then it easily goes through. And I have this whole loop. So the point of fastening off, let me take these off so they won't be visually in our way. The point of fastening off is, of course, to get, we don't want knots, we don't want to get rid of these ends, and to make sure this doesn't unravel. You're going to be washing your face or washing your dishes or however you use this cloth many times, throwing it in the wash machine, and so you'll want to make sure it will not possibly come loose. So you go to the back of your product, and as we talked about, this is kind of a reversible product because we go back and forth. We have fronts and backs, but decide which is going to be your back and go through here and try to go under some of these stitches. And we're going to go three. There's a rule of three here. And look what I've made a little mess here. The rule of three. We're going to go a certain amount of distance, at least an inch, one direction, and then back that direction, and back that direction, and then this is never coming out, ever. So you just kind of go down and see where you can go through some of these stitches. Don't want to have a big gap where you come in and out, because that'll... Okay. You probably won't use this big of yarn, and so it won't be this hard to work on. And look, I see several of these that'll make it easy. So I'm just going to run along this little row for about an inch. That makes it very easy. So I got several. So I can go along this row and pull that taut, but not too tight. And now I want to go back the other direction. Skip this little stitch so we don't lose our stitches. And you go as far as you can. See, I'm able to go several in that direction. And go back. Because you want to do three directions. This can't pull out if you do it this much. And here it is. We've gone three directions. I take my scissors and I pull this just a little bit. Cut it off without cutting those stitches. And when I pull it out here, you can't see where the end of that is. I'll do the same for the starting one. And we'll have a product just like this. We've done the exact same thing here. We did the chain stitches and we did double crochet back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And then we finished off both those tails. And this is your nice soft washcloth or dishcloth. And I think you'll like it very much.